Part 1 shows you how to make a cursor of your own. Part 2 shows you how to hide the original Windows cursor. Part 3 shows you how to make clicking on an object actually do something. And Part 4 teaches you how to shoot bullets towards the cursor. To make a cursor, right-click on the screen, click Insert Object, choose Active, click anywhere in the level. Double-click on it to edit it, and draw what you want it to look like. Now, click on the Hotspot tool, and click on the tip of the cursor. Like so. Click OK, and there you have it, a cursor. To make it follow where your mouse is on screen, go to the Event Editor, right-click on New Condition, right-click on Special, and choose Always. Go across to where your cursor is, right-click, Position, set X coordinate, retrieve data from an object, go to the keyboard on mouse icon, current X position of the mouse. Do this again, but for the Y axis, like so. Position, Y coordinate, retrieve data from object, mouse and keyboard thing, current Y position of the mouse. Click OK. It should now follow your mouse around. Finally, go back to the level editor, select the cursor, go to the runtime options, untick this one here, and set this to no. This will mean that the cursor won't get lost off the side of the screen at all, just to make sure. Go up to the event editor, right click on new condition, right click on storyboard controls, click start a frame, go across to where the mouse and keyboard icon is at the top of the screen, and where it meets up with that new event, right click, and choose hide Windows mouse pointer. When you play the game, you won't be able to see the original mouse, you'll only see the one that you have just created. If you want something to happen when you click on it with the mouse, go to the event editor, right click on new condition, go up to the keyboard and mouse icon, the mouse, user clicks on an object, OK, unless you want to change the options obviously, and choose the character that you'd like to be able to click on to do something. For now I'm going to choose my character. Double click on him. I'm going to make it go to the next level when you click on your character. So go across to the third event along, which is the storyboard controls, right click, and choose next frame. If I play the game, it should end the game when I click on the character, since I have no second level to go to. You have to make your own cursor for this bit to work. If you don't want your own cursor to be visible in game, simply select your cursor, and in its properties, make sure that this is unticked. This will make it invisible in game. If you want the character to shoot towards the cursor, right click on new condition, go up to the keyboard and mouse icon, the mouse, user clicks, set the options to how you want them to be, click OK. Now go across to where your character is, since he's going to be shooting the bullet, right click, launch an object, choose the bullet, launch in direction of, choose the cursor, click OK. In game, you should now be able to shoot towards the cursor.